Alright, so we're on our way to Goodwill to buy some treasures. So hopefully we find something good today. So we're crossing our fingers.
Walks out the door.
Don't cry, buy your bag and get over it.
And I'm not concerned with thought and polity.
It's a lot of men, I know I could find another.
All I know is that I'm always happy when I walk out the store. Store.
I think I'm supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, nothing to be playing with.
I love him, hate him, kiss him, diss him, try to walk him out.
I know I might come up as negative.
I be looking for labels, I ain't looking for love.
But relationships are often so hard to take.
And pride of dress has never broke my heart before.
And balling something.
Okay, so recently I have discovered Goodwill shopping. And it's the most incredible thing I've ever done. I started my job at Victoria's Secret, and I was like, oh god, I have to have all black. Like, I'm not gonna be able to do this in the summertime. So my mom was like, well, I'm not gonna spend the money on you. And I was like, awesome. So she was like, well, let's go to Goodwill and see what we can find, because it'll be really cheap. So I was like, well, that's gonna just be terrible. Like, I don't wanna go to Goodwill, I don't wanna wear other people's clothes. It's disgusting. So I reluctantly went. And when I got there, we started looking around. And while we were still amateurs at the time, it was still really cool. I mean, the stuff you could get, like I got a Neiman Marcus bag for like $3. It's incredible. So it kind of like became our little thing that we did. We'd go to Goodwill, you know, and we had a couple extra bucks to spend, and then we'd see what we could find. So now we are like the absolute pros at it. I mean, we're incredible. Nobody can touch this, okay? So I'm about to show you all the awesome stuff that I got at Goodwill. All for about $100, okay? Let's keep that in mind. Okay, so first, this is the purse that I was telling you about. It's a Neiman Marcus. Perfect condition. I mean, that's the other thing. Goodwill's not gonna sell anything. They've got a policy that they don't sell anything with stains or rips in it. So you always know, I mean, you're not going to get crap items unless you pick crap items out. So, it's got like that alligator skin finish to it, and it's really nice. And on the inside, you can see it says Neiman Marcus on it. And it's perfect condition. And it has this strap to it, which was great because it matched all the black that I had to buy. And it was really small, so it fit in my work locker. I love this bag. Like, I wear it so much now. And then the other things that I got, recently I went to the one in Naples, Florida. I think that the key for Goodwill shopping is to go to like a city where you know a lot of rich people live. So Naples, Atlanta, what's the name of it? Buckhead in Georgia. Just lots of different stuff, but it's really nice and it's really cheap, so that's the key. You don't want to go somewhere dingy. The one in Gainesville, though, is pretty good. So I got these Brooks Brothers loafers for $5. You can still see they're, like, perfect on the inside. And I was like, okay, I'm not passing that up. So those are $5. I don't exactly remember how much everything is. Usually shirts are $3.99, pants are $2.99, and dresses and stuff are $4.99. So next, I got this dress from French Curve,
And it's just a long black dress. It goes all the way to the floor. But the material is really just casual, kind of sporty material. And it's got a seam down the middle. Anyway, I love this dress. It's great. And I have an orange necklace that I wear with. It looks cute. Next, all my stuff is inside out, so I'm trying to flip it for you guys to see it. Next was this dress that cost me $4.99. And it's so pretty. On the front, it's sort of a velvet material, but you can see it crosses over. And this is like it's kind of see-through, a little bit transparent. And then on the back, it buttons up the back, and that's all see-through. It's really gorgeous. And like I said, that crosses over to the front. And it goes all the way to the floor as well. I don't know when I'm going to wear it, but I was just like, that's so pretty and so cheap. I have to buy it. Next is this pink satin shirt. I don't know if you can really see the color on here. It's like a really light baby pink. It's just really pretty. I love the cuffs on it. And at the bottom of the shirt, it has these cute little things. And it is from a place called Finamore. It's from Napoli. So, I mean, you know, something made in Italy, that's awesome. This was for Victoria's Secret. It's just a little shirt that I bought. It's like a little crew neck black shirt. But it's really cute, and I love wearing it. It's really comfortable. It matches a ton, and I wear it with a lot. So, next, I got this black and white gingham button-up. And it fits kind of loose, but it's really cute and chic. And that's from Ink, which is an expensive brand. Semi-expensive, not like through the roof, but still. So that's a really nice shirt. I love wearing that. And then I came across a pair of gingham capris that I was like, gotta have them. And they're just really cute. They're high-waisted, sort of like vintagey, and I just love them. These ones zip up on the side, so like right there. And they were only, I think, $1.50 or something. So I got two pair. They had a pair really similar, and I got another one that I love. I wear them all the time with everything. They match so much, and they're really comfortable. That's why I love them. So next, I got this dress, and I realized when I tried it on, it's homemade. But it fits me, like, perfectly. Like, it's incredible. It's like a miracle. And I was really angry because my aunt put it in the washer, and it shrunk. And I was like, you've got to be kidding me. That was such a killer dress. And so when I ironed it, it stretched back out. And I was like, oh, thank God. So this is the dress. It's also gingham. And it's got the waistband right here. And I'm probably going to have it hemmed a little bit, maybe. But it's still really cute, and it fits perfect. So love that dress. Next, I just got a black skirt. Like, I have a lot of black in here. Usually when I go to Goodwill, I just skip the colors and go straight for the blacks, white, and cream. Just because I wear so much of that, and they match everything. So it's also just long. I didn't try that on in the videos because there's not really anything to show. I have a lot like that, so. Next, I got this little blazer, which is really cute, and it fits me great. At first, I was like, that looks kind of disgusting because of the inside. Because I think blazers look cheap when they have a pattern on the inside. But it fits perfect, and it looked really cute. So I got it, and that was really cheap. Pretty much anything I show you is under $5. Like, I don't think I've bought a single thing yet that was over $5. Which, you know, it's really awful because when you go and you have to shop in a regular store, you're like, oh, this is so expensive. This is terrible. Like, I bought one thing in here that was $6.99, and I didn't know if I should do it or not. I was like, but it was two things for $6.99, so, you know. And then for work, I got these Banana Republic dress pants. They're wide leg trousers. They're just a really nice material, and they were great for work. They're in perfect condition. So,
see the Banana Republic tag?
I don't know. And they're really comfortable. Okay, so at the one in Naples, I found this scarf that I love. I love it. Looks really cute. Not with this, obviously, because it's striped. But I love it. And it was really cheap, like I said. So, and I love scarves. I wear scarves all the time. People always see me. They're like, "Why are you wearing a scarf in the summertime?" And I'm like, "Why are you dumb?" So I'm happy to find a scarf like that. Satin ones are the best in the summertime, I think.